Today we'll be making an authentic Hyderabadi Haleem or Daleem recipe. This recipe has been requested by Samina Sheikh. So this recipe is especially for you. We are going to make this recipe in a very simplified way. So for this I'm using dals, all the different types of dals, 2 tablespoons each. That's Tur dal, Masoor dal, Chana dal, or the Bengal gram, Mash ki dal or the Urad dal, and Moong dal. So we've just used about 2 tablespoons each of these dals. And I've added 2 tablespoons of barley. If you don't have that, you can use oats instead. And broken wheat, 200 grams. I've used the broken wheat, so this really simplifies the process. You can also use the whole haris wheat for this. And all these pulses and other dals, we'll be roasting it in a pan. This gives a really nice aroma and flavor to the haleem. And along with this, a handful of almonds. We'll roast them also along with the dals. And then we'll grind it to a coarse powder. This simplifies the whole process of making the haleem and it becomes really quick. And make sure you soak the wheat overnight. And if you don't want to go through that process, you can also roast the wheat and grind it in the mixer too. But I've soaked the wheat overnight and now I'm adding both of these together to the cooker. And along with this, we'll add 2 teaspoons of salt, 1/4 teaspoon of turmeric, and 2 glasses of water. Mix it well and some mint leaves for some flavor. When you pressure cook this, make sure first you cook it on an open flame for 2 minutes and then you close the cooker. And for the next part, that is making of the masala and the meat masala, you can use any meat, mutton or beef. I've used some fried onions, a handful of fried onions, 2 tablespoons of ginger garlic paste, 1 handful of coriander leaves chopped, about 10 to 12 mint leaves and about 10 green chilies. So we'll add this also to the cooker. Fry them for a minute and then these are the masalas, the whole spices that we'll be using. 2 bay leaves, 2 cinnamon sticks, 3 cloves, 3 green cardamoms, javitri or mace, peppercorns 1 teaspoon, cumin seeds 1 teaspoon, coriander seeds 1 teaspoon, caraway seeds 1 teaspoon. Let's fry the masala for some time, for a few seconds, and then we'll add 1/2 a teaspoon of turmeric, 3/4 teaspoon of red chili powder. Fry it for a few seconds and then we'll add in the meat. You can either use mutton or beef for this. I've used about 500 grams of meat for the recipe. Let's roast the meat in the masalas. Add 1 teaspoon of salt to this. 2 tablespoons of yogurt or curd. This is actually a very simple recipe except that you need to mash it up really well. But since we are following this recipe where we are just grinding the dal and using the broken wheat, the process is much faster. I've added about 1.5 glasses of water and we'll pressure cook this for about 45 minutes to 1 hour on a low flame. And the wheat is ready. I've pressure cooked this for about 1/2 hour. You can see that it's already all mashed up. We don't really have to work too hard on mashing this. So this is the most simplest procedure to make the haleem. Mix it well and make sure it's free from lumps like this. And now in the meantime, the gravy also is ready. The meat is cooked. आई एम जस्ट रिमूविंग दिस ऑयल विच इज़ कलेक्टेड ऑन द टॉप विच विल बी यूजिंग लेटर. रिमूव द बे लीव्स एंड सिनेमन स्टिक्स इफ यू फाइंड एनी एंड मैश द मीट रियली वेल. And now we'll add this whole gravy to the wheat. And along with this, I've added about 1.5 teaspoon of garam masala and 1/2 teaspoon of pepper powder. Let's mash it properly. We'll mash everything together. So this is the main process of the haleem. Otherwise, the cooking part is really easy. Add some ghee to it according to your requirement. And a handful of fried onions and some fried cashew nuts and some coriander leaves. You can also add in some mint leaves. You need to add some rose petals also at this stage, but I don't have them. If you have them, you can add some rose petals, some lemon juice and a little more ghee. Let's mash everything together really well and the haleem will be ready in no time. So this is one of the most simplest methods of making haleem. It's all ready to serve. Let's transfer it to a serving dish and garnish it with fried onions. The oil which I've left aside, we are going to first add that to the haleem. So instead of using extra oil, I'm using the same oil. And garnish it with fried onions, some coriander leaves, and lemon juice. Just place some cashew nuts and squeeze some lemon juice onto this. This is the most tastiest and the most simplest recipe to make this tasty and authentic Hyderabadi haleem or Hyderabadi daleem recipe. I hope you like this recipe.